Hi everyone, it's Happy Mail Queen. I wanted to share a few projects that I had created. I'm in a swap with Kameka, who is a touch of creativity. Hi Kameka. And I wanted to share the swap items that we agreed on. So Kameka had messaged me last month, and she wanted to do a swap. So I agreed, and we started chatting, I discovered, you know, because I started watching her videos and really loved, you know, her style. You know, she loves to make shabby chic projects and uses a lot of flowers and lace, you know, and the color schemes are pretty much the same kind of colors that I use. And so yeah, when she had asked me to do a swap, then of course I wanted to check out her channel and see, you know, what kind of projects she likes, and you know, that way I get a feel of what she would like from me. So I realized that she was a big fan of Creative Kelly from Cali, which, you know, I'm a big fan as well. I follow her channel, and she doesn't do a whole lot of videos nowadays, but just really fell in love with her style. And Kameka is also a fan, so we decided, you know, well, it was actually her idea. She said, hey, maybe we can do a Kelly inspired swap. And then she asked me, you know, well, what kind of paper do you want to use and what items do you want to do? And so we had agreed to use Country Escape, because that is my all-time favorite Tilda paper right now. And she wanted to do a mini album in a box. So we were to do a box with a mini album inside the box. We agreed on doing a banner, and she wanted the words inspire on the banner, so I had created that. And what else? And then I said, oh, let's do some mixed media stuff. And I think we're both fairly new to mixed media, so let's do a canvas. Those are the items that we decided to do. So let me tell you guys, you know, Countryscape, I love the Tilda papers, not only because I love the style and the color scheme, but also they give you quite a bit. The tags, you get three of them, like three sheets, which a lot of times, you know, other paper lines don't give you that. So as you can see, I've used up almost all of the first page, and I, you know, I still have so much more left of the tags, I mean of the cut aparts. They're actually cut for you already, but this is all I have left. I have like two sheets left, Kameka. I used up all of them, so and yeah, that was all that was left. So I need to get some more of this paper because I just love it. So let me go ahead and share the card that I made for her. So I wanted to create a nice pretty card. And again, this is Kelly inspired, a Kelly inspired swap. And if you guys follow Kelly, you guys know that she loves gorgeous girls. So you're gonna see a bunch of gorgeous girls. I think I put gorgeous girl images practically in everything that I made, almost. So there's the card, and I used this gorgeous girl image. I stamped her, and I don't know if she came out, and you know, I hope she came out okay, because this is the first time that I used my distress markers from Tim Holtz, and I actually used the watercolor paper. So I'm so used to Copics, and so I hope this came out okay, Kameka, because this is the first time I've ever like I said, use the distress markers, but I really wanted to try it, and I'm gonna keep practicing, so hopefully I get better at it. So I used, you know, of course, the Tilda paper. So love, love, love the Tilda paper, and I paper pieced her dress, again, I used my distress markers for her face, and I put one of my buttons, which is the not Michael's, but Joanne's, the buttons that I purchased from Joanne's, and these had the little bows on them, and I put my Swarovski crystal on there, and then I stickled her dress. Here I actually put stickles, and I also used the glitter that I got from Joanne's. Then I tried to use every bit of this paper because it's just so pretty. And I took out my small punches, and I punched out some hearts and the star. I thought that would be really cute. And I just popped them up on some foam tape dimensionals. And I put this Wild Orchid Craft cherry blossom here. Let's see, below here I put some trim, and this is a trim that I got from downtown LA. I actually went and got some trims there, and so, you know, watch out for my haul video on that, because I got some pretty good deals. Put some flat back pearls here, and I believe these are Jolie's from Michael's. Another cherry blossom here, and this is one of those cut-up parts that you get from the paper line, and it's very, very, very cute. I stickled it, and it says an offering of friendship. And then I got a new Sizzix die, and this is the bow die, and I can't remember exactly what it's called, but I think it's a bow die. It's one of the bow dies. And so I just made that and put some of this bling that I got from downtown LA, which I super, super love. The bling mesh that I have, you know, when you cut it, sometimes there's little pieces that's, you know, you can see on the ends. I love these. And, you know, the mesh bling, you don't get rhinestones. You know, they're sparkly like rhinestones, but they're not rhinestones. These are actual rhinestones on the mesh. So I love it. So then I put three, these are not Swarovski crystals, but they're just rhinestones that I got online, and they're still, you know, very, very pretty, and it's an aqua color. And let's see, and it's an easel card, so it does stand up like that. And this is one of the cut-up parts, again, that I pulled apart and stuck on there. I embossed this page here with an embossing folder that I had purchased from Joanne's, I believe. And I love this embossing folder. I forgot what it's called, but love it. And then I'm gonna put my message here. And I made a little pocket there, and here's the paper. And this pretty trim here I got from downtown LA as well, and it's so pretty. And here's the back, and it just goes right in there. Sometimes I make cards, and you know, I don't want to write on them. I know it's crazy, right? Because that's the purpose of them, but I don't know. So I made a pocket, so that way if she ever wanted to reuse the card or whatever, she can. And then I just kind of put my little logo there in the back, signed my name. So there's my first project. And then, so let me just show you the, right here, up here is the banner, and it's pretty big. And I didn't even string it yet because I knew it was going to be hard to videotape it. So I decided to just show you individually. So this is going to be a long video, guys. Hope you guys don't mind. But I'm going to show you some really pretty goodies. So, okay, so I did quite a bit on this banner. I, again, used my... I believe this is the Lacey banner from Spellbinders. It's one of their older ones. But I love, love, love this. It's like the perfect size, not too big, not too small. And I love the scallop edges here and the fact that it has holes there so that you can actually string it. So again, I adhered the paper, the Tilda paper. I made some rosettes here, and I used my doily punch, my Martha Stewart doily punch, because I wanted the edges to have that nice, pretty, doily look about it. Now these are from the paper that I had to actually cut, and they're the little plates. And what I did was I really wanted them to look like plates, like, you know, china. And so I cut it by hand, and then I glossy accented. And so I think it came out really cute. And then these letters here, these are alpha chipboard. That's actually from a cane company pack. And it's this one right here. And I've been holding on to this for the longest time and just never really got to use it. And finally I did. And I love these letters, they're so pretty. So it's by cane company. Okay. So here's my eye for Inspire. Let's see what else I did. I put some lace here, and it's hard to see because I covered it up. But I did put some pretty lace. All of them have pretty lace on and different laces. I also cut the bird here, and this is from a sizzlet dye, I think, that I have. And love that bird. And I just put a little rhinestone for his eyes. And let's see, I'm at 12 minutes now, so I gotta keep track of my time. I put this Prima flower here, Prima rose, that I got from the Prima outlet. And then I made my own little Tilda hearts using, I kinda like made my own template, and then I kinda got this idea from Amador. And I put the paper on chipboard and put holes to make it look like buttons. And then I put this pink twine that I got from Target. And then I put this little wing because I wanted it to have wings. But I don't know, I wanted a different look, so it only has one side. So each heart has one little wing, either on the right or the left side. So this is really pretty, and this is also Prima. And what else did I do? I also, underneath the flower here, I also put some fun fur. And then just put some random rhinestones there. And then I made this bow out of satin ribbon. No, I'm sorry, not satin ribbon. Seam binding and tulle. And I just really loved this two combinations of colors. I just thought it went well with the paper, and so I was just experimenting, and I just decided, let me just make a bow out of both of them, and there we go. And then I put this is a, I think it's a Jolie's or Recollections bling from Michaels. And then I wanted to put some dangles on the bottom, so I did just made a couple of bead dangles, and I love them. And this is inspired by Sabrina. She had I had purchased the large bottle caps charms that she makes, and she puts these dangly charms on the bottom, and I love them. So I love the colors, and so I wanted to kind of recreate that with the what are these rondelles. So there you go. So there's my eye, and they're all pretty similar. Here's my N. It's just sometimes I have the bird on the other side, the right side, and sometimes it's on the left side. And then I have the hearts and the flowers as well. So okay, you guys, I'm gonna do part two. Okay, so stay tuned for that.